Hey, I'm Blogger Marini, and in this video, I'm going to teach you how to create a website, whether you want to do it yourself or hire a designer. Be sure to stay tuned until the end because I have a super simple checklist that's going to help you set everything up from start to finish in just a few easy steps. The other day, we were at our condo association meetup in one of our friends was telling me, oh, I'm gonna quit my job. And I was like, well, what are you gonna do? He said, well, I think I'm gonna go to school and learn how to design websites. And I said,
oh, really? I made a video about how to do that. If you wanna watch it for free, you can do it in just probably like less than 20 minutes instead of quitting your job and trying to figure that out.
I'm not really sure how to talk about how he responded, but he essentially said,
no, I really want to learn how to code them.
And I was thinking, dude,
people don't code websites anymore. They hire people to do that.
What are you doing? You're like 40 years old. This is not what you should be doing right now. He didn't want to watch the video. He said he wanted to go to school for it. And I was thinking, well, the
school's called YouTube. You don't pay to go to school anymore. That's just not normal.
The whole point of the story is that it made me think about, okay, well, if I was going to create a website today, how would I create a website, or like how would I tell someone to create a website? And I just did this the other day for one of my businesses, Ambay Exchange. Honestly, I sell so much on Amazon and sell so much on eBay, I didn't really have a website, or I didn't really have a need for a website.
So I decided to make one.
The first step is probably to decide whether you need a website or not, because they have these things called landing pages, which I like to refer to as one-page websites. If you've ever heard of a lead page, there's also a company called Lead Pages, which is who I actually use to create these landing pages. They're just simple one-page websites where you can sell a product or service or get people to join a webinar or sign up for an email list, something like that. You've probably landed on one and didn't even know you landed on one. Hopefully that makes sense. If it does, hit that like button below this video so I know that it's making sense. If you need a full-blown website, you always have the option to build one yourself or hire a designer. If I'm going to build a website, I'm going to use GoDaddy's website builder because they use WordPress, which is probably completely over your head, but you're going to need to know that one day. So WordPress is a design platform. I use GoDaddy to host it. WordPress is essentially free, but you have to host it somewhere. So that means someone has to store your content for you. So I pay GoDaddy to do it, and I just use GoDaddy because it's all in one place. If you saw the tutorial that I did below the video a while back on my Blog and Brandy channel. Once you've found a design you like, you're gonna hit select and it's gonna install it. So this will show you how this theme works and what the tabs look like. And you can tell it's a little off, but you can change the colors to anything. You would see that I use GoDaddy super easy to create this website in like, I don't know, like 10 minutes. It's called their website builder, or GoDaddy website builder, something like that. You have the option to do a one-page website, or you have the option to do the full-blown website. So if I was gonna do it a full-blown way, GoDaddy would be the way that I would go. And I think you can even hire them to set up a website for you. It's probably gonna be really pricey, but I would suggest just setting up the website yourself first and then hiring a designer, maybe after you've put some of the content into the website, like some blog posts or gotten some of your about page info. Like, you want to have something to give somebody before they can design for you. That kind of leads me to the next phase of this process, which are themes.
Themes.
So a lot of people probably have no idea what a theme is, and I didn't either when I was starting my business. If you have this thing called a theme, or you buy one of these, say you're trying to create something like a scheduling type theme, a travel blog type theme, something like that. Okay, so essentially, instead of trying to build this whole website for yourself, you're installing a theme that already does all the things that you want it to do, or most of the things that you want it to do. And the best way to do this is to hire a designer to put this theme onto your website for you. Just trust me on this, because making all those little plugins work and making the theme look the way that you buy it doesn't work the same. I buy mine from ThemeForest or Envato Market. I recently just bought one that looks pretty ballin', and you can check it out in the description below this video. So for the theme that I installed, the theme itself was about $59, and then to get it installed cost me about $50. So to start the website all together, pay GoDaddy about $15 a year for the domain name, $25 a month for the hosting of the website. I paid a one-time fee of $59 for the theme, and then $50 to get the theme installed. Less than $150 for a domain and a website and hosting. That's what I paid. Hopefully that's not like too over your head. It's probably the easiest way to set up a website. If you really need help outside of that, I would suggest hiring a designer. And I know you're gonna ask,
where do I go hire a designer?
If I'm not gonna use this theme in a modern market and I just wanna hire somebody straight out. Just to give you some places that I've used before, you can reach out to somebody on Fiverr, F-I-V-E-R-R. You can find people that do tons of jobs on there. They can either build a complete website for you or they can install a theme for you and help you out with getting set up from start to finish. Another service that I've used is called Upwork. They have tons of people out there if you want to find just like a freelancer.
You can also hit me up. I don't know why you wouldn't do that. This person right here, you can hit me up and I can help you do that, or at least point you in the right direction.
So let's review how to create a website, or how essentially would I create a website. The first thing to note is whether you need a website or not. Do you need a website or do you just need a landing page, which is a one-page website? If you need a landing page, I would go with Lead Pages. If you need a full-blown website, I would start with GoDaddy's website builder and at least get something set up. The second part of that process is if you need something more advanced and you're going the website route, then you wanna go with a theme. Probably heading over to Envato Market or ThemeForest is always a great option, and where I head to go get my themes. And then I have them installed either through Envato's Studio Freelance Finder. I have them install it for me when I'm purchasing the theme, or if I wanna have somebody do all of this from start to finish, then I would say maybe head over to Fiverr or Upwork.
Or you can always just hit me up
and I can help you do it for yourself and your business. So how would you hit me up? Well, you could hit up the description below this video, or you could visit my website. Or you could just send me an email, brandy@bloggingbrandy.com, where I can direct you where you need to go. Okay, so now you know how to create a website for yourself, either by yourself or hiring a designer. But do you know how to set up the rest of your business, like your email and your social media and all of the things that come along with that and all the fun stuff that I mentioned? Then you're gonna want something like my startup checklist, because I didn't know these things either. So I put them all into a checklist so that you know, like, hey, I need a website, and here's where I go to get my email set up and how I get my social media. And checklists below this video and the tutorials and the videos that I mentioned and all the good stuff. If you aren't checking the description below this video, you're missing all the goodies. Until the next time, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next episode of
these wonderful and amazing tutorials that I make.
Thanks for watching. I'm Blogging Brandy, and I'll see you in the next video. I really hope this video makes it out on time, because I'm so pressed for time while I'm recording this, but I hope that it seems beautiful and seamless, just like every other video that I make. But more importantly, what are we even going to talk about in this video, and who the f- am I, right? Who am I? That was a little explicit. It's definitely not who I am, but that could slip a time or two, so, you know, just keeping it real, boss to boss. But what are we going to talk about today? And I don't know why my hand is like that, but what are we going to talk about today? That is a great question, Brandy. Why would you, you know, ask that? Set everything up. This is not going well. This is why I only record once a month. I'm so not in the mood to do it.